In today's video, I'm going to show you a step-by-step walkthrough of my application for a DBS check. So here we go. This is my application for a DBS check that was requested by my employer. So I received an email from my employer to apply for a basic DBS check, which costs £23. I've put the official gov.uk website link in the description box below for you. And here it states, request a basic DBS check. Apply for a basic disclosure and barring service check to get a copy of your criminal record. This is called basic disclosure. It costs £23 and it's available for people working in England and Wales. And you can also get a basic DBS check if you live in Northern Ireland or Scotland, but the job you're applying for is in England or Wales. The check will only show convictions that are not spent. For example, some types of caution will disappear after 3 months. You must be 16 or over to apply, and it usually takes up to 14 days for you to receive your certificate. What you'll need to apply for a basic DBS check, you'll need all your addresses for the last 5 years and the dates you've lived there, your national insurance number, your passport, and your driving license. So this is an online application, and as it states, the service is available from 8 a.m. to 11:30 p.m. And as a warning, it does state here, before you start, make sure a basic DBS check is the correct one for you. For certain roles, your employer may need to apply for a higher level of criminal record check. My employer did tell me to apply for the basic one. Please do double check with your employer if that is the specific one they want you to apply for. So how to pay? You can pay for a basic DBS check yourself, or you can get someone to pay for you. For example, an employer or relative. You can pay with a debit or credit card. You can also use Google Pay or Apple Pay. If you pay the fee yourself, you need to pay it when you apply. And if someone else pays, they must pay the fee within 10 days of your application being submitted. So we'll go ahead and click on Start Now. First up, validating your identity. Before getting a criminal record check, you need to validate your identity. You can do this online for free using gov.uk Verify. So some checkboxes that we have to tick in agreement before we can proceed. I agree to the basic DBS check service using my name, date of birth, and address provided by my digital identity. I have read and understood the basic DBS check online application privacy policy, which explains how the DBS will process my personal data when I'm applying online before my application has been submitted, and an acceptance for the cookies policy. I'm going to tick all those boxes and then click on continue. So the next page is sign in with gov.uk Verify. So have you used gov.uk Verify before? Of the two options we have, this is my first time using gov.uk Verify, or I've already signed up for Verify, including if you've got partway through creating an identity account. So for myself, I've never used gov.uk Verify, so we're going to select this is my first time using gov.uk Verify and then click on continue. What gov.uk Verify is? So gov.uk Verify is a secure way to prove who you are online. It helps protect you against online identity theft. The disclosure and barring service uses Verify to stop other people getting a criminal record check using your details, as it stops someone from pretending to be you. How it works? You create an identity account with a company that meets government privacy and security standards. The company will ask you questions and check your identity documents. It will never share your information for any other purpose without your consent. So the two companies we have here are Digidentity and Post Office. We're going to click on continue. So about you, are you 20 or over? So I'm going to tick yes. And have you lived in the UK for the last 12 months? Again, I'm going to tick yes and then continue. Which of these do you have available right now? This will help us tell you if gov.uk Verify will work for you. The more items you have, the more likely it is that you can verify your identity. I'm going to select all four options. So a valid passport, a valid driving license, a phone that can download an app, and a credit or debit card. Then we can click on expanding what gov.uk Verify uses these for. So the companies can check your passport and driving license against official records. They can also confirm your personal details by accessing information like credit records. This will help them be sure it's really you. If you only have one photo identity document, you will also need to download a free app and take pictures of it. This will prove that the ID is yours. The companies will only use your credit or debit card details as more evidence of your identity. They cannot see your transactions and cannot charge your account. So I've made my selections and now I'm going to click on continue. So pick a certified company to verify you. One of these companies will create your identity account. You can pick either company, there's more than one, so that you can choose who verifies your identity and everyone's information is not stored in one place. It usually takes 15 minutes to prove who you are. You can then use your account to sign into other government services. So we've got two choices here. So it's Digidentity and Post Office. So I'm going to click on more information for Digidentity. Swift, safe and secure. Digidentity was founded with the sole purpose of protecting people's online identities. In an ever more digital world, we offer easy to use applications and combine smooth usability with government grade security. We are an international company and leading provider of digital identities in the Netherlands and Great Britain. We service people with over 150 different nationalities and are one of the few parties equipped to help foreign workers with their online verification in Great Britain. Last year alone, our software realized 250 million authentications and protected the digital identity of more than 17 million people. We take great pride in our approach to privacy and security. Your data will not be shared or used for other purposes. By registering your Digidentity, you'll be able to access government services like filing your tax or checking the information on your driving license in a swift, safe and secure way. So I'm happy with the information provided and I'm going to choose Digidentity. All right, so the first step is creating a Digidentity account. I then receive a confirmation email and I have to provide the code that's within that email. So here we have it. Confirm your email address. You signed up for a Digidentity profile with this email address. Please confirm it by filling in the confirmation code on the Digidentity registration page. Here's the confirmation code. And if you did not sign up for a Digidentity profile, please ignore this message. So we're going to copy and paste that code in and then click on confirm email address. Next up, account setup. So provide your mobile phone number. Please enter your mobile phone number. We will use your phone number for identity verification and to contact you, for example, sending a confirmation code. So I'm going to enter the number and then click on next. So confirm your mobile phone number. Your mobile phone number has been saved. I'm now going to receive a confirmation code on that number, which I then have to enter into this field, confirmation code, and then click next. So just retrieving that confirmation code from the text received and then entering it into this field and then clicking on next. Secure your account. Your mobile phone number has been confirmed. How would you like to secure your account? There's two options here. Use the Digidentity app, automatically log in with your smartphone or tablet using virtual smart card, or use text messages. Security codes will be sent to your mobile phone. I'm going to opt for the use text messages function and then click on next. Next up, personal details. So provide your current details. Please enter your official name, as can be found on your passport, driving license or identity card, your date of birth and your gender. If you have been known by another name in the past year, you will also be asked to provide details of your previous names. For example, if your name changed when you got married. All relevant fields must be filled in. So I'm just going to have my British passport in front of me and then verbatim just copy and paste in the information as it appears on the passport into all of these fields just to make sure everything stays nice and consistent. Clicking on saving. The next up, provide your current address. For the next step, we require your address details in order to verify your identity. You will need to provide at least 1 year of address history, including your current address and any previous addresses within this time. Again, all relevant fields must be filled in. So we've got the country, and then we're going to enter the postcode, and it will then populate the address for us. And then clicking on next. From the populated choices, I can drop down on the box and pick my particular address, and then click on next. And here, following on, please check that your address is filled out correctly. You can modify it here if needed. So I'm just going to give this a good once over, make sure all the information is here. If there's anything missing or anything else I need to add to the address, for example, a house name, then I can do so and amend it before moving forward. But it looks good to me. And at the bottom here, it says, when did you move to this address? For example, December 2010. If you cannot remember exactly when you moved, please use January by filling in 01 and the year you moved in. So I'm going to put the month and year when I moved into this address and then clicking on next. So confirm your personal details. Check your details below and if anything is incorrect, edit it before clicking next. So here in the personal details, I've got the current name, date of birth, my age, gender, and confirmation of my name. So it's been since birth. And then address details. So current address, country, and then the date I moved in. So it all looks good to me. I don't need to edit, but I do have that option available in each field to edit if I need to. So definitely do that before you move forward. But it looks good this time around, so we're going to click on next. So prove your identity. Add evidence. To prove your identity online, you must be able to verify two or more identity documents in your name. This includes at least one photo ID document, such as a passport, driving license, or national identity card. Having these documents to hand will help speed up your registration. So we're going to click on next. So the first question, do you have a passport? I'm going to click on yes, I do. And then the next question populated is, do you have a smartphone that can download apps? In this case, I'm just going to click on no, I don't. And then click on next. So we can only accept details of Great British passports. Fill in the details exactly as stated on your document, even if you have since changed your name. So here we're going to get all the information from the bio page of the passport. That's the page with your photo on it. So the passport number is in the top right hand corner of your bio page. It's a series of numbers. And the rest of the information we're going to lift off the same page as well, such as names and date of birth. And the issue dates of the passports again, along with the expiry date, are also on that bio page. So we're just going to copy and paste all that information in and then click on next. So do you have a valid UK photo card driving license, full or provisional? Again, yes, I do. So I'm going to select the top option and then click on next. Only UK photo card driving licenses can be submitted. Old style paper licenses are not accepted. Fill in the details exactly as stated on your license, even if your name has changed or you have moved addresses. So just like we did with the passport previously, I'm going to have the driving license in front of me. And again, verbatim, just copy and paste the information over from the driving license fields onto this form. So once I'm happy with that, I'm going to go ahead and click on next. And now we're on to the third stage, prove your identity. Add identity. Do you have a mobile contract in your name? So from the options I have, yes, I do. No, I don't. And yes, but not with me. So I'm actually going to click on no, I don't. And then click on next. And here it states, based on the documents you've provided so far, we are unable to complete your verification. To continue, you're required to use a digital identity app to verify your passport or driving license instead. This involves taking a photo of the original document and of yourself. By providing these photos through our secure app, more weight is added to your verification than using the input method from before, since we can be more certain that you are in possession of your document. This gives enough additional assurances to complete your verification. So here I'm asked, do you have a smartphone or tablet that can install apps? So I'm going to click on yes, I do, and then next. So upload your passport or driving license with a digital identity app. So download the digital identity app by searching for digital identity in the app store on your smartphone or tablet. Then you open the digital identity app on your device and you tap the scan QR code button in the app. That's the big green button at the bottom of the screen. And then you scan this QR code. Point your device's camera towards the QR code. You should see what the camera sees on the device's screen. And then follow the steps on your device. And finished. Once you've completed the steps on your device, this page will automatically refresh and go to the next step. As you can see, there is no next or save tab at the bottom of this page. We simply have to continue on our smartphone and then the PC's page will refresh and it will continue with the application. Prove your identity. Progress summary. Please wait while we verify your documents. At the time, on a Wednesday at this time, the average processing time of the document is about 3 minutes. If this takes too long, then you can also choose to log out and complete later. So we can see here that the driving license is currently in process, verifying the document details and awaiting selfie verification. That was through the app from the previous page. Passport has been accepted. So having just waited 3 minutes, this page automatically refreshes. And there we have it. Digital Identity has verified your identity successfully. You will now be automatically redirected to gov.uk. Verify in 20 seconds. And there we have it. Digital Identity has verified your identity. You can sign in wherever you see the gov.uk verify logo with your Digital Identity identity account username and password. You can now apply for a DBS basic check. Great, so we're going to click on continue. So is this your full name, date of birth, and address? This is your name, date of birth, and address from your digital identity. Just making sure the information is correct. My name, my full name, my date of birth, and my current address. I'm happy with the information here, so I'm going to select yes, and then continue. Have you ever been known by any other names? You must tell us about all other names you've used, including middle names. For example, you may have changed your name through marriage or deed poll. Only your current name will be displayed on your online result. For my own situation, I have never been known by any other name, so I'm going to select no. Click on continue. So what is your sex? We need to know your sex so that we can check police records. I'm going to click on the expansion of what personal details will appear on my certificate. Your sex will be printed on your paper certificate. However, it will not be displayed on your online result. If you're transgender or non-binary and are concerned about completing this application, you can read our guidance on transgender applications and you can contact the DBS Sensitive Applications team if you do not want to reveal details of your previous identity on your paper certificate. So in this scenario, I'm happy to select male and then I'm going to click on continue. Right, next up, where were you born? So we've got the country and town or city. Well, I'm going to relay the information that is in my British passport, which has the city and country listed in it. So I'm just going to copy and paste that information in just for consistency's sake and then click on continue. So have you lived anywhere else from 2016 to now? You must tell us about all the addresses you've lived at in the last 5 years. You can't leave any gaps, but it's fine to have overlapping dates. You need to include any secondary addresses, for example, student accommodation, or if you work away from home. So I'm going to click on the expansion, what is a secondary address? So if you're a student and live in student accommodation during term time, but live with your parents or a similar permanent home address in the period between academic years, you need to tell us both addresses. If, for example, you work away from home and spend months living an alternative address that's not your permanent home address, you need to tell us this alternative address. If the nature of your work means that you often spend 1 or 2 days in different places away from your permanent address, we don't need details of each of the places you visit. So I'm going to select no and then click on continue. Do you have a UK national insurance number? If you can't provide a UK national insurance number, you can still carry on with your application, but it might take us longer to process your check. So I'm clicking on I don't know my UK national insurance number. It expands to you can find your UK national insurance number on your payslip or letters about tax, pensions or benefits. So using my payslip, I'm going to find my national insurance number, select the yes option and then click on continue. So I'm going to select the yes option, it's going to expand and there I can enter my UK national insurance number and then I'm going to click on continue. Do you have a current UK driving license? If you can't provide driving license details, you can still carry on with your application, but it might take us longer to process your check. The driving license you provide can be any current full or provisional driving license, photo card or paper. So I do have the photo card available, so I'm going to select yes. And per the handy information here in the link, I don't know my driving license number, it says your driving license number is in section 5 of your driving license photo card, and it normally starts with your surname. So we'll click on yes and enter the entire and fairly long driving license number and then click on continue. And do you have a current passport? If you can't provide passport details, you can still carry on with your application, but it might take us longer to process your check. If you have an Irish passport card and want to provide this instead of your passport, you can enter the details of your card here. So I do have my current UK passport. I'm going to click the yes option. It expands. I'm going to enter the passport number that's on the top right-hand corner of the bio page. Again, that's the page with your photo and details on it. So the top right-hand corner of that page is the passport number, which is a series of numbers. And then on the same page, it will state country of issue. So we're going to copy and paste those two pieces of information into these fields and then click on continue. Where would you like us to send your certificate? We can send your certificate to your current address, another personal address, for example, a family member, or your employer. If you send your certificate to another address, make sure you are able to check the information on it is correct. And if you send your certificate to a non-UK address, it could take longer to arrive in the post. So on this occasion, I'm going to choose the to another address option because I want to receive my certificate at my place of employment so I can then easily hand it over to my employer. So here we go. I'm going to enter my workplace's postcode first of all and then look up the address. That's my employer's address. I'm going to select it and then click on continue. Now the next page says, what address would you like your certificate to be sent to? I've got some more fields here with the address broken up into different sections. I'm just going to make sure all the information here is correct. I'm going to click on continue. So what is your email address? The email address you provide should be your personal one. If, for example, you provide a shared email address, others may be able to view the result of your check. And then we'll use your email address to send you general information about your application and send you links to track, view, and share your result online. You will not be able to view your result online if your check reveals a criminal record. So I'm going to enter my personal email address and then click on continue. Can we send you text messages about your application and codes to view your result online? We'll only use your mobile number to send you progress updates about your application and to send you a security code to let you view your result online. If you do not provide a mobile number, you will not be able to view your results online. So I'm going to select the yes option, and then it expands and asks two questions. Which country is your mobile number registered in? So I'm going to enter United Kingdom. And then what is your mobile number without the country code? It's not going to have +44 or +91. Or +323, just going to keep it 07, just like we would give our number to someone else in the UK. It's going to be 07, blah, blah, blah. Enter that information in and then click on continue. So there we have it. We'll send text messages to, and your number looks like a correct mobile number from the United Kingdom. Great. I'm going to click on continue. Who is paying for your check? So we have two options here. I am. So payment is due as soon as your application is complete, and you can pay with a debit or credit card. Google Pay or Apple Pay can also be used. Or someone else, for example, an employer. We will send you a payment link by email, which you can forward to someone to pay on your behalf, or you can use yourself. So in my scenario, my employer will be paying. So I'm going to select the someone else is option and then click on continue. So check your details. Please check your mobile number and email address are correct. You will need a correct mobile number to receive updates about the progress of your application and to receive a code that enables you to view your certificate online. We will send you a payment link by email, which you can forward to someone to pay on your behalf, or you can use yourself. We're going to look at this summary, make sure all the information is correct, and then we're going to click on continue. Review your application. So here we've got the name, date of birth, sex, place of birth, and other names, and address history. So this is all information that we've already entered, just a summary, making sure there's no typos or any errors, giving it a good once over. Application details, next up is the national insurance number, driving license number I put in. Very easy to make typos in those numbers because they are quite a long series of numbers, so well worth double and triple checking with the original document that they come from to make sure that they are indeed correct. And then the address where I want the certificate to, again, making sure it's all copacetic. Happy with that, click on continue. So by continuing with your application, you confirm that the information you've given is true and the fee of £23 will be paid using a payment link. You could be prosecuted if you knowingly give false information in your application. We have to select the I agree to the terms and conditions box and then submit application. So awaiting payment. What happens next? We have sent you an email containing a payment link with instructions. If someone else is completing your payment on your behalf, you must forward the email on to them. If you wish to pay, you can use the payment link yourself. Payment will need to be made before your application can be completed. And if payment is not received after 10 days, your application will be cancelled. So it's imperative that once you get the link with the email, you forward it and let your employer know ASAP. And here is the email that I received from the basic DBS check payment link. So what to do next? Dear, your application for a basic check has been submitted. Payment now needs to be made before your application is processed. What you must do now? If someone else is completing payment on your behalf, you must forward this email on to them. And if you wish to pay, you can use the payment link yourself. To complete the payment process, visit the payment page. So we have the link there to click on. And once payment is complete, we will send you an email. If someone else has paid on your behalf, we will also notify them. If we do not receive payment within 10 days, we will cancel the application. The payment amount is £23. So all that's left to do is forward this to my employer, let them pay, and I'll receive the certificate in due course. So I hope you liked that insight into the DBS check process and that you found this video helpful. If you did, please do give it a like. Do consider subscribing if you haven't done so already. Why not share this video with someone else that you might think will benefit from it? And feel free to leave me any comments or questions, and I'll get back to you as soon as possible. Many thanks for watching this video, and I'll see you in the next one.